It doesn't matter if you have a website hosted elsewhere and you want to transfer it to Hostinger, or if you have website files still sitting on your computer. Getting them hosted on Hostinger's server requires you to have a web hosting package. Every package essentially offers the same features and speed, but comes in different sizes that can support more website visitors at the same time. So choose the plan based on how many visitors you think you'll get, and make sure to activate an exclusive 10% discount by clicking the link below and entering the code EMITREVIEWS. You also get a free website name if you buy a plan for at least 1 year. So keep that in mind. Okay, once you're inside your Hostinger dashboard, you'll need to set up your plan and claim your free domain name. For the name, you can obviously choose whatever you want. For the plan setup, none of the options really matter except for the data center location. Choose one that's closest to your target audience. I'll go with Massachusetts. Now, if you want to upload a website you have already created offline, you'll need to click on Manage next to your web hosting plan. Next, click on File Manager and look for the public HTML folder. At the top right, you'll see a little arrow that will allow you to upload files and folders. Click on it. First, upload all of the files. Once that's done, upload all of the folders. Now, if the file you want to use for your homepage isn't already named index.html, change it to index.html. Or if you don't want to mess up your menu structure, open your .htaccess file and add a directory index line with the desired file to be your homepage. And there it is. That's it. Now, I do understand that not all of you have website files just laying around offline, and that you would like to migrate from another web hosting provider where you already created your website. You can have Hostinger support do it for free, or do the migration yourself. I'll show you both methods. So, one, to get Hostinger support to migrate for you, just click on Add Website, Migrate Website, and choose your hosting plan. Here, you can enter the website name you have on Hostinger that you want to migrate to, and then enter your current website name you're migrating from. And finally, provide Hostinger with either your WordPress login details or your website files, and they'll migrate it for you completely free of charge. But this takes time, and sometimes ain't nobody got time for that. So let's say you're on a tight schedule and want to handle it yourself. If you're hosting a WordPress website, you can head on to your WordPress admin panel on the site you want to migrate. Then click on the plugin tab and add a new plugin called All-in-One WP Migration and Backup. Install it and activate it. Then you should see this new plugin on your toolbar. Once you drag your mouse over it, you can see the import and export options. Click on export first and choose file. This basically sucks up all of the website content from the server and creates a neat little file with all of that information for us. So next, go to Hostinger and simply create an empty WordPress website. Nothing matters here because it will all get overwritten by your imported website. We just need to have something. So once inside your WordPress install on Hostinger, repeat the steps with the all-in-one WP migration. Except this time, instead of using export, use import and choose the file you've created before. Now, if your website is bigger than the maximum upload file size, there is a way to bypass the limits by editing the PHP values. Head over to your Hostinger dashboard. Under File Manager, you will see your website files. Click on public HTML, then double click on .htaccess. Here you will see a bunch of confusion. No need to understand it all. Just scroll down and paste the values I have prepared for you in the description. Once you've done that, edit the upload max file size and post max size to your needs. By default, these options allow up to 2 GB, but you can change them. For example, I'm gonna make them 10 GB. So I converted that to megabytes and enter the value 10,000. Once you're done with the filed upload, your old website design and functionality will transfer over to Hostinger, and even your WordPress logins will stay the same. However, sometimes these file uploads simply crash, and it's impossible to get them to 100%. In that case, you have a third option, using a backup. The plugin we're using here used to have backup functionality included for free. Now it's a paid feature, sadly. However, if you install an older version of this plugin, the free functionality is still there, so I'll leave a link for this older version of this plugin in the description. To install it, just go over to your plugins, add a new plugin, and upload this zip file. Now that you have the older version of this plugin, if you go to your file manager, then public HTML, WP content, and click on AI1 WM backups, you will access the plugin's backup file storage. There, drag and drop your .wpress file like I did here and back out to your website. Once you click on the plugin and head over to backups, you should see your file hosted as a backup. Click on the restore button and voila, your website is migrated, bypassing all of the limits and all of the weird loading bars. And keep in mind that now you're a Hostinger user. That means you have access to their tools and, more importantly, support. So feel free to always contact Hostinger support, as in my experience, they did not fail to help out and sometimes even offered to solve my problems themselves. And that is a huge thumbs up for the provider. But if you're looking to create a website from scratch, watch this video next as I go into a step-by-step tutorial showcasing how to do just that and create an awesome looking site in just 20 to 30 minutes. Good luck, and I'll see you around.